Hello, hello, beautiful people. You are warmly welcome back to today's video. My name is Rose Kelly for those that are new in this place, and this is a Rose Kelly Ministry platform. You are warmly welcome to today's video. I thank you so much for my new subscribers, my old subscribers, my retaining subscribers, and even those who are watching without subscription. You are all welcome. And I believe that today, we are going to be blessed by the blessings of God upon all of us on this platform, upon all of us watching this moment. Thank you, Father. Thank you, the Spirit of God. Thank you for your direction. Thank you for giving me and granting me the ability to obey for this video. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. Guys, actually, this video, I am making this video out of obedience, and it is a dream that I had, and I had to make this video because I needed to make it. Actually, in this video, I want us to pray, and in this prayer, I want you to pay critical attention. I am going to give you the direction that you have to take in making those prayers. I'm also going to give you scriptures, and I'm also going to show you some of the things that you need to do and how you need to do it to see that effective, you know, prayers. Okay. Actually, I also want you to, you know, support this channel by, you know, praying with me. Especially praying with me whenever you go on your knees. Remember me, because these days God is showing me a lot of things, and some of them are too heavy for me to come out here and tell people, because I don't know how people are going to take it. But sometimes I need to come here and, you know, show you these things. So what is today's video is all about? Today's video is all about an evil altar that has been revived, that has been restored, and that has been fortified against people. An evil altar. In this video, there has been an evil altar that was destroyed by the individuals. Individuals like me. I'm using myself as an example. Maybe I have prayed for, I have seen delays in my life, I have seen hindrances and setbacks in my life, and because of that, I have, you know, engaged in prayer and fasting and offering and whatever that I needed to do at that time. I did it, and by God's grace, that altar of evil was destroyed. But what I saw in this dream was that after some time, the evil people or the evil person who were behind these altars have come back and have revived this altar. So somebody might be asking me, how would I know that this, you know, this dream that you have concerns me? This is what you should know. The first and the foremost thing you have to know is that all of a sudden things were working well for you. You see, like everything is okay now. Everything was okay. But from nowhere, things started to, you know, to break out. Things started to go out of hand. You used to have sales. All of a sudden, you cannot have sales. People used to love you. People used to bless you. But all that have just shortened up. When you go out to look for ends meet, nothing is coming up. You are not a lazy person. You are working hard. But at the end of the day, you are not seeing the result that you have to see. It can be a financial delays. It can be the fruit of the womb delay. It can be a marital delay. You are due for marriage. You know, that guy you've been going out with, that lady you've been going out with, been courting with, all of a sudden the lady doesn't want to marry you again. All of a sudden the man doesn't want to see you again. Listen, there is a delay altar that has been fortified and revived in your name. And this video, when we go later in the video, I am going to tell you everything that I saw. I'm going to tell you the scriptures that I have been given. And I'm also going to tell you how you need to pray this prayer and the source of offering that you also need to place on an altar that you need to build for yourself to be able to replace the other altar that was laid down for you. So if you are interested, I want you to, you know, take a short commercial break, and I will be right back to tell you everything and the scripture, everything that you need concerning this spirit of delay altar. You are warmly welcome back from that short commercial break. Yes, we are going straight. I'm not going to waste your time. I am not here to waste your time. All I want you to do is, first of all, I want you to take your Bible, and you are going to, you know, have two scriptures. I'm going to leave this two scriptures on your screen for you. The first scripture that I want you to read is what it is, the Psalms 18 verse 29. Psalms 18 verse 29, the Bible says, but because of you, but by you, I can run through the troop and I can leap over the walls. I can run through the troops and I can leap over the walls. That because of God, because in this case, it is only God that can save you. It is only God that can save me out of this situation. So we are going to let God know that with Him, that hindrance that is placed before us as a wall, because of Him, we'll be able to jump over it. We are going to tell God that because of Him, that is why it is good to what? To personalize your scriptures. That because of you, this hindrance, this border that has been placed before me, I will be able to leap over them. Because of you, any delay that has been set in the realms of the spirit, me, Rose, because you, God, you are on my side and you are going to be my what? My strength, I will be able to overcome. Because of you, I will be able to run through the troops. I don't care how many they are. I don't care how many they stood, how many that stood against me. Because of you, me, Rose, I can be able to run through them and succeed. I can be able to run through them and overcome. I can be able to run through them to make me the head and not the tail. That is the first scripture I want you to take. The second scripture I want you to take is in Psalms 24 verse 7. The Bible said in that 7 said what? Lift your heads, O ye gate, and you everlasting gate. No matter how long you have been there, the ancient gate that will not be opened unto me for me to see my success. Today, in the name of the God Almighty, I am what? I am commanding you to lift up your head. I want you to understand that whatever situation you are going through, they have ears, they can hear you. So it is about time you speak to them. It's about time you command them. It's about time you let them know that they don't have any place in your life. They need to move. They need to be opened for the glory of God to be seen in your life, for the man strong and mighty to be to be demonstrated in your life. So therefore, you are calling them. You will mention them by name. Whatever circumstances that you are seeing and you are experiencing as a delay in your life, being it financial, being it marital, being it instrumental, being it mental, being it health-wise, being it ministry, being it faith life, whatever delay that it is, you will mention their name and you will tell them to be open. You will tell them to give way. You will tell them to open up. Listen, God has given you power upon your tongue. You can't do this without God. The Bible said that in the book of 2 Corinthians, it said, for the battle is not ours, but then we need to take our position. This is your position by standing in the gap and speaking what you need to speak for that demon, for that spirit of evil to leave you. Now, these are the two scriptures that you need to what? You need to have. Get yourself a glass of water, a bucket of water. Pour a salt into it. Okay? Add these two elements together. Thank God for it. Thank God for the salt. Thank God for water. What did water stands for? Water stands for abundance. Water stands for life. Water stands for purity. What did salt stand for? Salt stand for taste. Salt stand for covenant. Salt stand for abundance. Salt stands for expelling and destroying evil powers. So when you combine these two, they are coming to what? To the thing that you want to see. You want to see life of abundance. You want to see purity in your life. You want to expel evil spirit, evil altars. So combine these two. What are you going to do? I want you to ask God for God's forgiveness. There should be anything in your life that will be a hindrance to this prayer. May God intervene. I want you to also know that the reason why you are using the element of water is that the earth that we are standing upon, or we live in, is upon the waters. There's a water beneath us. Okay? So wherever that altar is, you want this water. You want to use this water as a point of contact. That through this, that after your prayer, God should release power in this water. And that as you use this water to bath yourself, and as this water goes back to the earth, and as it runs through, wherever that power is, wherever that altar is, may this water reach there and destroy. May this water reach there and make that altar powerless, inactive. May this water reach there and what? And do your heart desire. What you want the water to do will do for you. My dear, I used water recently for something, a prayer. And in that prayer, what I told them, by God's grace, I pray a particular and a specific prayer. Within 24 hours, I've seen my result. And this made me understand that it is the way we pray, it's the way we say our prayers that makes it effective. And the way I pray this prayer is what I'm showing you. If you want an effective prayer, let the water know that God has given her or him or her power. And ask God, because it's God that has created this water, it's God that has placed his what power upon this water. And your words that you are going to speak are going to activate that power, and that power is going to work for you. That is why you can still drink this water and nothing will happen. The same water, you can still use it and something will happen. Why? Because you have activated the power of God upon it. So now, what do you do? When you finish this prayer, when you have prayed your prayer, go and use this water. As I've told you, when you're using the water, let the water go. You are sending the water. They can hear you. The water can hear you. You are thinking that that water can hear you. Send that water on that assignment. When you finish, get money. Okay? Get any amount of money. This is your offering. Now, when you get your money, once you are making this prayer is not a day prayer. You don't have to make this. I cannot tell you make this prayer 3 days or 7 days or 1 week or whatever. You are going to pray. When this prayer has worked, you will know. Things will start to change. And when things start to change, this is where you have to be very diligent. You don't have to stop praying this prayer. You might not pray that consistently, but you have to be vigilant and continue to pray this prayer, because you have to remember that in this dream, this has been destroyed before, but then the enemy came back. And we all know that when the enemy comes back, he's not coming alone. She's not coming alone. She's coming with other powers. And this time around, they are coming with full force. So you don't want to stop praying. I don't want to tell you do this, because somebody will do this 2 days, it will work. Somebody will do it 1 week, it will work. Somebody will do it 3 months, it will work. It all depends on the level of the demons or the powers we are fighting. So when you finish, anytime you are making the first week that you are making this prayer, let that money as a source of offering. You don't have to be, you know, forced with any big amount. Use anything that you can afford. Pray. Once you are making these prayers, make sure that this money is on that altar or is with you once you are praying. At least a week, after praying for about a week, go out there and give it to any beggar. Go out there and, you know, give it to an orphanage, if you can go there. If you can go to the old age people who need help, somebody who needs help urgent, you know that this person needs this urgent, you know, help them with that amount of money. Buy food for them, pay their bills for them, whatever you can use that money for, do it for them. This is going to be your offering. This is going to, activate that power for you to sustain you. Go and do good to somebody with this money or the money you've been using. And make sure that the day you are going out to do this goodness should be Tuesday, Thursdays, or Saturdays. These days are good for giving out to the needy or to the poor. Yes. And now, before you also go and give this money out, I want you to declare goodness. I want you to prophesy it, that you are using this as a point of contact, that from today you will experience breakthrough, that as from today you will see the blessings, financial increase, financial doors are open. Every altar of delay and evil is what aborted, is destroyed by the power of God. And from today, instead of what delay, there is a speed in my life. Instead of delay, there is a speed in my ministry. Instead of delay, there is a speed in my career. Instead of delay, there is a speed in my children. Instead of delay, there is a speed in my marriage. Instead of delay, there is a speed in me getting the fruit of the womb. Instead of delayed, I declare speed like the days of the prophet. The Bible says, and the prophet overtook the child of what? Of the king. It is about time for you to overtake. It's about time for you to be on speed. The speed that cannot be stopped. You are going to be unstoppable. I am, begin to declare all the good things that you want to see in your life. And when you finish, go and give this offering to somebody. I hope this, this video will be of help. I hope that somebody will take care of this dream and will pray according to the lead of the Spirit. As I said, I will bring it to an end of this video. If you have not yet liked our videos, what are you doing? Please like the video and remember to subscribe and put on your notification so that whenever I upload a new video, you will be glad and you will have our notification and you can watch our videos. I want to bring this video to an end today and stay tuned. There are more videos that are coming. There are more prayers, prophetic prayers that are coming up. I want you to glue to this channel because God is using this channel to change lives. I want to say bye-bye once again. Bye-bye.